Y'all ever notice that this fan is like totally in the wrong spot and it makes me look like I have horns? Do y'all see that? It looks like horns. Maybe we should turn it this way. Well, that's a little bit better. At least I don't have horns anymore, right? Okay, so, hey y'all, it's Whitney Nicely, and we are talking about three ways to find sellers who are open to creative financing, all right? And creative financing is going to be subject to lease options, owner financing, a wrap, you know, something besides going to the bank or paying all cash. That's creative financing. And lots of people tell me that they can't find anybody. All right, so the top three ways to find sellers who are more than likely going to be open to this, if you can present it properly, is to find empty, vacant, abandoned houses. That's the first way, all right? Vacant, empty houses, like nobody is living here. Somebody probably inherited that thing and they live three states away and they don't even know where 123 Main Street is and they have no interest in coming back and doing anything to it. And so if you can get a hold of them and present an offer and give them some money and start making them payments, boom, that thing is probably free and clear. We could probably set up an owner financing deal in like 10 minutes, especially if they've just had to pay the property taxes on it. Do you know how bad people hate to pay taxes, especially property taxes on a place that they don't own? I mean, that they don't live in, they own it. They do own it. Time out. They do own it, but they don't live in it. They could care less about this house. Do you know that people forget they own houses? Literally, there are people out in the world, probably in your area, maybe not in your zip code, but definitely in your county, who have forgotten that they own a house in that county. If you can find that house, if you can get a hold of that seller and you can talk to them and structure a deal and offer them some money in exchange for the house, let's do it, baby. All right. The second group of people that are super open to owner financing or creative financing, I should say, I call these people bridge people. And I talked about this on a podcast yesterday, Ask Ferris. So bridge people are, they graduated college, they graduated high school, and they bought a little two-bedroom, one bath. And that was fine while it was just them and the dog. But then, you know, they had a wife or a husband move in, and that the two-bedroom, one bath wasn't big enough anymore. So they needed a three-bedroom, two-bath. Maybe they had kids in the first one and it wasn't big enough, so they needed a three-bedroom, two-bath. And they had a good job, they had plenty of money, and they were able to buy the second house without selling the first one, all right? So they just started renting the first one. They're kind of accidental landlords. They're bridge people. And not like under the bridge people. They're bridging life. That's what I mean here, not under the bridge people. People who are bridging life. So they're living in the second house, and then the next kid comes along, and then the ducks and goats and everything else come along, and suddenly it's not big enough. You know, we're in a subdivision and we need to be on land. So they move from the first house, they move to the second house, and now the second house still isn't big enough. So they move to the third house. And, you know, 5, 6, 7, 10 years go by, and now the kids are older, they're in baseball, they're in dance. Now, the parents, the grandparents are older and they need more care. Maybe they need to move in. And then, you know, job, and we're trying to move up the ladder. And like, while we're living in this third house, or maybe it's the fourth house, maybe it's the 18th house. I don't know. But, you know, they've moved on and not sold off the first two houses, three houses, eight houses, whatever. But at some point they wake up and they go, oh my gosh, I am so overwhelmed. Maybe the straw that broke the camel's back is that one of the tenants called and had a problem. Or maybe one of those first two tenants moved out in the middle of the night. And maybe, honest to goodness, guys, maybe while they're in the third house and they got stuff going on with their parents and their in-laws and they got stuff with the kids and they got stuff with cousins and, you know, there's just a lot of stuff going on. There's a portion of the world, of the population, in that bucket of the third house. And these first two houses where they became accidental landlords, it's just too much. They're just overwhelmed. They don't know what to do with it. They can't stand it anymore. And sometimes when those people move out of the first two houses, they just make the payments and leave the house empty because it's easier to just make the payments and throw that $600, maybe $1,000 at the bank every month than to take the time and energy to list the house or take the time and energy to find another tenant to go in the house. They just as soon pay it and deal with it later and deal with it later. And then a year goes by and then 2 years goes by and then 3 years goes by and nobody's been in the house and they've made the payments this whole time. If you can come in and say, look, dude, I got you, okay? I'm going to start making these payments. You're not going to have this hole in the boat anymore. I'm going to find somebody who's going to love this house. They're going to buy it. Sorry, the internet paused. I'm going to take care of this for you. This is going to be amazing. Don't you worry about it. You go ahead, take care of your parents, take care of your kids, take care of whatever else you got going on. I'm going to take this problem away from you. Those people, the bridge people, the people who are accidental landlords, they're going to kiss your toes. They're going to be so excited that you have come into their life. And yes, those people are in your county. I take that back. If you're in California, they may not be there. You may need to go somewhere else. No, I'm kidding. People have those situations in California too. So as far as I'm concerned, you're going to be able to find all these people in your area, in your market. Okay, so the third group of people, the third way to find sellers who are going to be open to creative financing. Let me think of how I want to say this. They're broke. Okay, they're broke, okay? Maybe they tried investing, maybe their goal was to become an investor, and maybe they got divorced, maybe they had a kid with an unexpected hospital bill, maybe they had a parent with an unexpected something or another, but something has happened in their life, and they're broke. Before they start getting late on payments, before they file bankruptcy, before everything goes down the toilet in one big flush, there's a chance you can come in and talk to those people and help them. And maybe not help every property that they have, but maybe help a couple of them. Maybe they're over leveraged. Maybe they have got in a bad spot and they had to roll their credit card and their car and their hospital and everything into the house, and maybe it's over leveraged now and they're super stressed because they don't hardly have enough money to make the payment and they definitely don't have enough money to list the house and pay an agent to sell it. So they're in a rock and a hard place. If you're into creative financing, you can, I don't like it, but you can buy a house if it's over leveraged. I don't like it, but you can, and you can help those people. And instead of them pulling their hair out and going crazy and possibly risking, you know, their future, you can help those people. All right? Creative financing is perfect for when they owe what the house is worth, but they're willing to give you 10 or 15 or 20 years as long as they don't have to be responsible for it anymore. Those people are going to love you. And I don't have any trouble finding sellers who owe as much as the house is worth, and they know that they can't list it because they don't have enough money to pay an agent the 6 to 10% that it would take to put it on the MLS and sell it. Whereas if I come through and I've got a creative solution, they love me. They love me. And I can turn around and I can offer that house out to tenant buyers, and the tenant buyers will line up at my door to be able to get into a situation like this. So, there's sellers out there in your area. There's empty houses in your area. There's people in bad situations in your area. There's all sorts of people who are hurting and dying inside for you to come and give them some solution to their problem. Now, if you want to talk to happy sellers who have no problems, then yeah, you're probably not going to find anything. But there's enough people in America who have real estate issues that everybody should be swamped with deals. I'll show you how. I'll show you how to actually get in front of these sellers. Those are the sellers that you want. Tired landlords, people who have inherited properties and they don't live around, bridge people, they're all awesome. And I can teach you how to get in front of them. There's, you know, like 6 different ways to find these people. If you want to know more, go to WhitneyNicely.com. I'll be glad to help you. If you have any questions, send me a message. But get out there and go buy something. You're being selfish by holding your goals deep down and not helping your neighbors. Get over your fear. Get out there. Start making some offers. Start helping some people. Get in a good rhythm. Buy those houses. People are going to love you. All right. If y'all have any questions, let me know. Go to WhitneyNicely.com and check it out. I'm doing a 40 Facebook Lives in 40 Days challenge. And so I owe you another one for today because I had a Facebook internet issue yesterday. Not techie. You don't have to be techie to do real estate. So if you have any questions, let me know. And I will be on to do another one. The other video I'm going to do today is mostly for agents, how to make more money by investing than listing houses. That one's going to be fun. All right. Y'all let me know if you have any questions. I'll talk to you again later. Bye now.